It's always good to see you, Stephen. Happy Halloween to you. Happy Monday. We were talking about the Comic-Con that took place last week, and I've been reading a couple of... Whenever I read a foreign policy hot take, I'm always like, do they really know, though? And so, which is always why I like to run it past you. Because, for instance, I was looking at a couple of different headlines. One, China's Xi Jinping now has unlimited power and is going to use Taiwan as a distraction from internal powers. And others are saying, well, this means, because of the position that he is in now, that they are absolutely, they are going to be invading Taiwan at some point here really soon, maybe not. It just seems really kind of, I wanted to kind of get your take on all of this and sort of, you know, just break it down for us.
Yeah, well, thank you, Dana. I mean, really, this is just one of those areas where if you're a serious analyst, you have to acknowledge what you know and what you don't know. And there is no one worth their salt that actually knows whether, when, or how
right.
Xi Jinping is going to do anything against Taiwan. They have certainly threatened Taiwan for a very long time. He's amping up those threats. It would be immensely irrational on one level for them to do that because they can't attack Taiwan without attacking their own economy. But then again, this is the government that's attacked their own economy with COVID zero policies and genocide in Xinjiang and supporting Putin's invasion of Ukraine and all that fun stuff. So you can never say never, but absolutely zero humans outside of the leadership compound itself have any idea whether, when, or how China might actually make a move. And so the people of Taiwan have to live as if today could be that lucky day.
Right.
And the people of the United States have to take the threats at face value and prepare. But really, we don't get to know, so we have to try to deter as much as possible and help those who are in the front lines help themselves and maybe be lucky enough to deter this kind of crazy action. And it would be crazy.
You mentioned the COVID zero policy. I saw just a day ago, BBC had a report how Chinese workers, they had been, I guess, locked down. And by lockdown, I guess, kept as hostages inside the Apple, one of the iPhone factories. I know they've been trying to relocate things to either the United States or India. But they said that there were 10 people who were videotaped jumping a fence outside the plant. It was a manufacturer of Foxconn in one of their larger business areas. They said that I don't know how long they had been there. They'd been there for quite some time, but they broke out and they said that they wanted to get out of the campus. They've been there for days. And that's pretty serious to lock them in. And I saw another picture where they can't even get, you have residents who can't even get on a bus unless they hold up their phones and it has the green code on it. And if it's not a green code, that means there's no bus riding for you. Go back to your lockdown. That's nuts.
It's even worse than that. I mean, if you get a yellow or a red, apparently an alarm goes off and everyone runs away from you like you're a leper. And other people come and swoop in and take you away. So, I mean, you have a misfire on this software AI, and you're in a world of hurt, China style. So, yeah, it's one of the most dystopian things you could ever imagine. The manufacturer of iPhones, I mean, it's really kind of a poignant story because so many of us have an iPhone or something similar in our hands. And if you went woke in recent years trying to demagogue against the United States for its alleged sins, where do you stand now on what's in your pocket? And so, I mean, it's a massive, massive problem for the woke corporate leadership and their supporters. But this China dystopian images, I mean, it's been some time. It's just no joke. If the alarm goes off, people are literally running for their lives to get the heck out because they could be locked down for a month with terrible food, no communication, and nowhere to go.
That's just crazy. We're talking with our friend Stephen Yates. They said Foxconn acts as a supplier to U.S.-based Apple. They have thousands of workers at one of their complexes. They have not actually provided an official count as to how many are infected. But that's psychological warfare.
No, it's horrible. I mean, this is the same company, though, that used to have a suicide watch for its workers, and it had a very uncomfortable rate of known suicides or reported suicides based on the working conditions. I mean, these people come from all over in China. It's a set of parents who are sending their kids somewhere to work way beyond full time in a dormitory situation, no social life or real upward mobility, but they can make a little bit of income beyond if they stayed home.
Yeah.
For those of us that are in America, we don't have to cry crocodile tears because these people are allowing a communist government to impose this on them. At the same time, I think the corporations that are engaged in this, especially because of what they try to demagogue about climate and other things being a higher priority, this is a pretty serious human rights situation on its face. Mm. And the world can see it, and they probably ought to fess up.
Last thing for you, talking with our friend Stephen Yates, you can find him, follow him on Twitter at YatesComms. This is a story that involved Catherine Engelbrecht and Greg Phillips and looking at 2,000 mules, although Catherine Engelbrecht has been working with voter integrity for quite a number of years. And they have been in court over this story and some of the claims that they have made about the CEO of the software company that tracks the behavior of U.S. election workers. The guy's name's Eugene Yu, the founder and CEO of Connec. And apparently he was supposed to keep the company data in the U.S., but was caught storing it on Chinese servers. And that was one of the allegations that Engelbrecht and Phillips had made, that they were accused of, I guess, defamation or engaging in, you know, character smearing. Although he was arrested in L.A. County last week, apparently because of this. And he had this huge contract with L.A. County. They were tracking worker schedules, training, payroll and communications, but then keeping all of this stuff on Chinese servers. That's why would they need to keep it on Chinese servers? I don't know if you knew anything about this or have been following it, but this is an odd story.
Yeah, well, from the election integrity point of view, my America First Policy Institute colleagues are all over what the right processes ought to be that are rational and easy, making it easy to vote, hard to cheat, all that stuff. But one major, major no-no is allowing any of this data to go anywhere outside of your jurisdiction. Now, I've seen elections held all over the world. One place where I've seen it most of all is in Taiwan. And in a nation of 23 million people, about half or more of them actually exercise their right to vote. They count all paper ballots hand-filled out by election night. They have almost no contests. They have witnesses from the candidates there to watch the count, verify the count, handle the disputes on site. There's no excuse for us to have any other system, really, here in the United States. But the last thing we should be doing is exposing any data to storage in China, because we know that they don't just sit around and hold that for a rainy day, whether it's TikTok scraping up things to manipulate Americans or otherwise. They don't take things they don't intend to use against us.
Yeah, you bring up a good point, too, about the TikTok thing, because it's not necessarily that they're going to do. It's all about influence and psychological disruption, too. That's a whole other issue. Stephen Yates, as always, we appreciate your time, my friend, at YatesComms on Twitter. Thank you so much for setting us straight on some of these issues. We appreciate it.
My pleasure. Take care.
Of course, you too.